hasn't always been this way.
All right, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, there is the field that we reported in the morning, the Cowpea project field in the University of Cape Coast. This afternoon, I have come back to ask the men about what they are doing. As you can see, they are taking some measurements of the plant.
Are you taking on each plant?
Okay, on each plant, you are taking about, now I think, 5 parameters.
Oh, okay.
Now.
Which are?
Which are the terminal leaf length, the terminal leaf breadth, diameter, the plant height, and the number of branches.
All right, I believe that you've done your best. I will move to your deputy to also ask him some few questions. Gentlemen, good afternoon once again. Your name again, please.
Good afternoon, Ebenezer.
Okay. I could see that as your boss takes the measurements of the plant, you're also putting down certain things. I don't know how you are able to arrange them. Looking at the sheet that you're holding, how will you be able to know that this one is for plant A, this one is for plant B, and in that order?
Oh, okay, that's nice. Thanks for the question. This actually sheet, it's been divided into sections. The first one, you have the genotype. So for easy identification, you write the genotype. As you said earlier, you have different varieties here, and so for that matter, you have to identify each one by.
This is the cowpea field. So far, so good.
You should know what's in your room. What should you kill?
I'm washing in here.
But I still
have some. Did you not go to the second?
No, I did not.
Yes. So we send back and moved it second stop.
After Christmas.
Man, look at you. Bankina. Bankina. Man, how you could hire your man?
About our fair, mommy, a father.
value. Odi tiye mu. Opo do hwe. Iko apa. Wo wo metu. Jumaza awezi. Aya ko bu bi sade. Na gbe bu su wo ye ku a. Brana bo hwe. Bo hwe. So wo mi bo hwe. Banta banti brazi. Santum hwe. What is Santo ye pede mi tire. Oni ya oho. Bo mo zina na chipe. Chipe.
Say dry o say yeah dry o
this one
na wo hu say asupa na wo say ebia e kesi na wo say ebia a control weeds no na wo hu say wo a wani gi hu say na e betimi na e pa biara say 10 o say 20 o wo be select na ya ticket enti eno na next year no anchor for prisons musabe kan bi na mo adua afen su farmers akuafo nsusu on baba be hwe Niamu maye no, no mo answer asuya free hanmo, no mo selecti, se niamu mo be selecti. Enti ene e selection. Ah, mo ankesangsa niamu pe se ye di mamu na mo dua, you know, manage hu no. Ha, na ti se yen researchers no ene mo nia ye crop, ene a selecti cowpea no. Enti se di brewa, wa wonim se niamu wa chusu no, ene ye di brewa, enti wani begi hu se wo be dua.
Crop sciences at the University of Cape Coast are appealing to government to include cowpea as one of the crops selected and the government's planting for food and jobs program. They argue cowpea, which is consumed by majority of Ghanaians on a daily basis, is capable of solving the country's food security challenges whilst also helping reduce the dependency on imported legumes from neighboring countries. Project manager Dr. Aaron Tete Asari of the Department of Molecular Biology and Biotechnology made the appeal on behalf of his colleagues after inspecting an 8-acre cowpea farm cultivated by inmates of the Ankafo maximum security prisons to supplement their food supplies. Richard Kodunako has more.
Cowpea is the cheapest source of protein for everyone in both rural and urban communities in Ghana. But cowpea production in the country is very low in spite of the high consumption of the crop in Ghana. It is consumed in most homes and very common to find people patronizing wachi and gari and beans. The nutritional value of the crop is said to be very healthy compared to meat. But the worry many scientists have is that most of the cowpea consumed in the country are imported from Burkina Faso and Niger to supplement that of the local market. Under government flagship projects, the Planting for Food and Jobs, the scientists and the project managers were expecting cowpea to be selected among the list of crops under the project, but the crop is conspicuously missing in the list. The project manager, Dr. Aaron Tete Asari of the Department of Molecular Biology and Biotechnology, is appealing to government to include in the list of crops since it will cut down the importation of the crop and have other beneficial uses for the country.
And in the school system, the feeding programs by government, cowpea is the main source of protein in the diet. When it comes to the prison service, the prisoners consume a lot of cowpea in the diet, in their daily diet. In the sense that fish is expensive to buy fish to feed them. I must say that cowpea production in Ghana is relatively low. It is known that government to incorporate cowpea, because among all the crops that have been listed, cowpea should have been the major leguminous crop.
Recently, after the training of farmers on the various varieties of the crop of the cowpea species, the farmers were given the opportunity to select the best improved cowpea varieties of their choice to be developed for planting in their respective farms. Among the farmers were authorities of the Ankafo maximum security prisons.
We are all aware that cowpea has protein content, and this our inmate need this protein content to perform a lot of activities. That aside, this farm, usually we have to buy fertilizer to fertilize the land before we cultivate other crops like the cereals. But when we cultivate it, it improves the soil nutrient, and it also don't let me sort of harbor the inmates for nothing. They get something doing, they produce, and then they eat, and that I think is in good order.
The Farmers Fields Day forms part of a project being undertaken by a research team involving scientists from the College of Agriculture and Natural Sciences and the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research and the University of Cape Coast. It is being sponsored by the International Treaty on Plant Genetic Resources for Food and Agriculture. Through this project, the scientists have developed over 22 varieties of cowpea with distinctive features. Richard Kodinyakun, Joy News, Cape Coast.
Sclerotium, do you experience?
They are all here.
You do experience it?
Yeah, you do experience it. But the two common ones are these two. The macrona shown very well when there's dry stress.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So during the dry period, that's where you see it most.
The rainy season is the Rosettonia that we have.
We screen a lot of this in alpha and beta lines. Now we generate some crosses and seeing the segregation, we checking the segregation issues, and then try to improve one of our important lines that has also shown to be very
certain. One of the P students.
Okay.
So I'm waiting for it.
So I've given an instruction, so as soon as I get it, I will send it to you. You send me an email, I'll send it to you. I'll put it into the mail.
This one, I gave them some they will come and put it just in the soil.
Typically, when you enter the cup of food, I understand. Yeah. When the thing is not supposed to dry, and the mocha is green, and you see yellowing inside the
striker.
So you see the UCC.
It's true.
It's not a sign of maturity. It's striker, if you see. So you go under there, and you see. Figure out if you look at this one. You can compare to the other. So you go closer, and you see striker.
It's not a sign of maturity,
but then the effect of the
So you just planted them.
It's a hotspot where
this food we don't put any other this thing apart from cowpea.
Okay.
Every year we first try to artificially infest this thing, and every year we put striker sick
so that you can have this
get them when it sees the base. So every piece of this thing has striker in there. So what we have here is you put them in qualifications here.
So like I said earlier on, what's the salad is you have seven contact numbers. It's a Cowpea UCC Cowpea Straga resistant varieties. So this is one of the farmers. This is
West.
But in all we are in Upper West, we are operating Sisala East. Sisala West.
You're in charge of
what? I collaborate with the East. But I do occasional visits to Jirapa. We have the Mother Trail and Laura.
Laura. Okay. So we'll be going to Laura.
Yes, Laura Tapia.
Okay. Okay. That's good. You are doing a good job.
Thank you, really, sir.
I really appreciate you.
Thank you, sir. You are
doing very well. This is what we needed from the research front.
Yes.
Okay.
And people like it a lot.
Okay.
They use it for the wachi.
Okay, for wachi.
Yes, please.
That's great. Okay, that's good. Wow.
So they prefer this material?
They prefer this material.
So sometimes...
Because this material, the grain size is bigger than their local material. And the number of pores that you get...
Is the next thing. So you organize, you and who?
Myself and the AE.
Yes. So you organize and then I will come over. And then we'll have a good interaction with the family. Because last year I missed it. So
yes, sir.
If we are able to organize it, it will be good.
Okay, sir.
Then they will do further selection.
Okay, sir.
But in fact, your recommendation will factor it.
Okay, sir. Yes.
Yes, dog.
But last year, Upper West, your yield was higher than the Upper East.
Yeah, because of Tumu. You know, Tumu soils are different from Laura. The whole Upper West is Laura and Jirapa, based on the soil analysis, Asare. They are having the worst soil intent, and they are the struggle infected.
But Tumu soil, there, he said, was.
Oh, so Tumu last just, year was Tumu, yeah.
Tumu
yeah.
is just like a Bona and a half Winchi area soil. There, but you can farm without fertilizer, but you can harvest maize. As compared to Laura districts.
Wow.
And then Jirapa, we are having the forest soil and struggle infestation.
So, how do we get soil? How do we get a soil?
That is the soil.
That's it.
No. I want us to take some sample.
Oh.
Because this thing is worth analyzing and this thing.
We can just dig out. We have a poly bag here.
Sisegum. Prof, ja, now this is a goom.
No, you, let me.
You can even use a stick.
Let me take
it. UCCL. Yes. UCCL. Okay, then. Thank you.
thank you.
Thank you very much. What's your name? Thank you.
This work was provided by Dr. Masari and Professor Michael Tinko. This will be our kind of presentation, from introduction, the materials and methods, down to some references that I consulted. Cowpea is an important name in our part of the world, and even beyond. There's a study that's by the gene diversity, which was also low, and the mean gene diversity was 0.4570. Now this was the result from multi-striker resistance testing. The 1897 gene was confirmed to have resistance to all the races but the SG4 race from Benin, that was part of the newly discovered race. Saccharose was used as a result. Thank you.
Thank you, Frank, for this wonderful presentation, and you are right on time. So, internal assessment. I'm handing over to you.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. First, let me congratulate you for. Please, I want to acknowledge the presence of the Vice Dean. Then I owe that is Dr. Noah.
I'm up for 6 copies of times. My supervisors, Dr. Hiro Masari of PCC and Dr. Francisco C. of Sari Banda Research Station. This is going to be my outline of study. I'll take you through the introduction before we go into the references and consulting. Cowpea, eaten on the platter, is a very important crop legume in Africa. Respond to the question is, the instrument that were used for the collection of the data were questionnaires made of both open-ended and closed-ended questions, then interview with key personalities. The data collected from this were subjected to qualitative analysis using SPSS.
In fact, zinc and iron deficiency is a serious issue in sub-Saharan Africa now. And currently we are developing a proposal looking at bioavailability of zinc, iron, and folate in cowpea foods. And so in breeding and developing new varieties, if any of a cultivar is found to have high iron content or high zinc content, it will go a long way to solve these malnutrition deficiencies among populations, not only in Ghana, but sub-Saharan Africa as a whole. And in our case here, we have UCC Eli, and that has a high value for copper, zinc, and then also Apagbala is shown to have high zinc content. Then selenium is also, I think for this work, for most work that we have seen, nobody has done studies on selenium. And selenium is known to have anti-cancer properties. So if you have a cowpea with high or adequate content of selenium, and then cancer patients or people eat, it will protect them from cancer, I mean suffering from cancer, or could suppress cancer development. And so we have found out that these lines 484, again, 153, 473, and then 513, as well as the IT 08K, and then 473. They all have the requisite selenium content and then iron content, and this makes them to stand up. And if you realize all through, 484 has been mentioned a number of times in terms of its nutritional qualities. However, it's susceptible to striker, but then it becomes one for the certain sector, it can be a very good candidate. And then besides two, it's a very good source of material for feather breeding because of its high mineral content. Well, on the whole, considering the presentation that I've made so far, the summary of it is that these copies that have been listed here, besides UCC, all these copies are potential candidates for a demonstration farm for the Barata Release Committee's inspection, based on both the yield and their striker resistance status, the nutritional resistance status for the northern sector. But this particular line is still going to be a check because of its susceptibility to striker for the northern
sector. So, unless you have enough money, invite them another time. So let us explain all that we have.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Professor Sabri.
The project is really a discussion. We're trying to reduce the number. I think we've seen the comparison between the on station and on the farm. And when you go for the such meetings, the results you present, do you consider that as also a criteria?
Okay, first of all, we always want on-station data